Hello everyone, today we're making Marie Callenders Meatloaf and Gravy. This is a quick video of before I put into the microwave. I'm gonna flip it over the instructions. It says right here to cut the film, cook on high for 4 minutes, stir the potatoes, cook an additional 2 to 4 minutes, and check to see the fuck is cooked thoroughly, handle when it's hot. Again, this is Marie Callenders Meatloaf and Gravy. Okay. Here's what the finished product looks like right out of the microwave. You can tell it's still steaming hot. I'll wait for it to cool down and then I'll give you the little taste test. Okay, so we're gonna do a quick taste test and I don't have my tripod, so bear with me if the camera's gonna be kind of the shaky side. Anyways, this is a quick taste test and look at the thing right here. Okay. First things first, I'm gonna try the meatloaf right here. Let's mix some with the gravy on top too. Get that flavor going. Wow. It's not bad. I'm not really a meatloaf eater. Like, I'll eat like Salisbury steak, but for what it is, it's pretty good. It's another bite. Get some of that plenty gravy on top. Get some of this mashed potatoes. Again, we gotta put some more of that gravy, because that gravy is actually really good. Pretty good. Now, but last but not least is the corn. I haven't tried the corn yet. Try to get this corn up right here. The corn is just like every other like frozen vegetable you get from like the freezer, so. But overall, I like to say this this frozen meal, especially for dinner time, it's pretty good. Would I get this again? I definitely would get it again. It fills me up, the flavor is there, and it definitely surprised me for eating meatloaf. Again, not really a meatloaf eater, but for me, the flavor is there, and I do like the gravy. And the texture of the meatloaf is right on top. Anyways, any more videos, stay tuned and find out.